LinkedIn is finally letting you put your captions on videos. This is a great day. Except it's not that easy. See, they don't have a bot that auto-generates your captions or lets you do captions right there in the platform. Instead, you have to upload an SRT file. And I don't know if you've tried to do this recently, but SRT files are extremely finicky and not exactly the easiest things to create. Today, we're going to talk about the 5 things every SRT file needs in order to be readable by LinkedIn and any other platform. So first thing is first, every SRT file has to be an SRT file. So it needs to be UTF-8 encoded. And if it's not encoded, you have to put it into a text editor, so Notepad or text editor, and you need to save it. And when you save it, it's going to automatically save as a .txt file. And instead of that .txt, you want to make sure you change that extension to .srt. Okay, so now for the actual contents of your SRT file. The very first thing you want to make sure you have is your sequence number, starting with sequence number 1. Sequence numbers are used to make sure that the right captions are showing at the right time in the right order. Okay, so once you have your sequence number, you're going to hit enter and you're going to start your next line. And the next line is going to have your in and out times. Now, these in and out times are where a lot of mistakes can be made because you have to have 2 numbers for your hours, a colon, 2 numbers for your minutes, a colon, 2 numbers for seconds, a comma, and then 4 numbers for your milliseconds. Now, with all of those different moving pieces, it's really easy to make a mistake, so make sure you're always paying attention to the punctuation and that there are the right number of numbers in the right spots. That means putting in zeros if it's a singular number. All right, and then you have to use 2 hyphens or dashes or whatever you want to call them, and then a greater than sign, and then you have to put the out time, which follows the same format, 2:2:2, 4. Okay, you have your sequence number, you have your in and out time, now you need to hit enter one more time, and this is where you put the captions. So now you put all of the words that you want to show during that in and out time. Okay, so we have 4 of the 5 things we need so far. We have our SRT file, our sequence number, our in and out time, and our captions. So what's missing? You need to go through and double check that there are no extra paragraphs or enters or spaces, whatever you want to call them, in between each of your sequences, and that there's not an extra one at the very end of all of your sequences and subtitles. So that's it. Well, I say that's it, but if you upload one of these files to LinkedIn and it comes back and it says that it's not formatted correctly, it's likely that you messed up on either the sequence number, the in and out time, or the extra spaces. And while that's not a hard fix, what's hard is going through all of the captions, because for 30 seconds of video, you could have 300 words, who knows? When you use Quick, our AI automatically captions your videos for you. And at the very end, you get a captioned video that has all of the captions burned in and an SRT file. So if you just want to have your video and then have LinkedIn put the captions on for you, you can just use your regular video and then upload the SRT file separately. And that way you still have a burned in copy for any other platforms that you want to put the video on, or if you want to send it to a client, what have you. Be sure to subscribe so you can get more tips on how to better use video for your content strategy.